This week on The Travel Detective, it was once known as the cigar capital of the world, which is why today it's still home to the Cuban sandwich. It's just one of the many hidden gems of Tampa. I'm Peter Greenberg. Those stories and more in this week's edition of The Travel Detective. It's the largest city in Southwest Florida. It's got a great culture and art scene, great nightlife, an amazing opportunity for sports fans, and of course, it's got the water. Let me show you some of my hidden gems of Tampa, Florida. Tampa was established in 1824 as a U.S. Army outpost called Fort Brooke and became the incorporated city of Tampa in 1855. The population grew quickly in the late 1880s with the discovery of phosphate and the arrival of the railroad and the cigar industry. One of my favorite hidden gems in Tampa is located, well, quite literally in the middle of nowhere. It's at the corner of 15th Avenue and 15th Street off the I-4. If that sounds confusing, not a problem. Just ask the locals, they'll tell you how to get here. It's called La Segunda Bakery. It's been in the same family for 100 years. Now, you can come here for the cookies, the cakes, the pastries, or the Danish, not a problem. But the locals know better. They come here for the Cuban bread. It may look like a loaf of French or Italian bread, but make no mistake, Cuban bread is different. Authentic Cuban bread, like the loaves they make here at the La Segunda, have a very light texture and are full of huge air pockets. And it's got a thin, papery crust. It's the only bread you can use if you want to make an authentic Cuban sandwich. And if you want to find another use for that delicious Cuban bread, look no further than the Columbia restaurant. It's one of the world's largest restaurants and has been serving Floridians for more than a century. It's been in the same family for five generations. And their nightly flamenco shows have been a staple for over 40 years. And they still make the once very popular, but now hard to find, deviled crab croquettes.
But the real key is to go off the menu and inside the kitchen, because back here, you don't order the little croquettes, you order the big ones, right?
Sure do.
Now, Andrea, what's the history of this?
This was my grandmother's recipe. So this, and I'm sure it was probably her mother's recipe. So it's a multi-generational recipe that's been evolving ever since then. Takes 3 days to make.
3 days to make?
3 days to make.
Wow, and what's in this?
You've got crab meat, of course, onion, lots of garlic, tomato, green peppers, and then it's wrapped with a combination of American bread and Cuban bread, and then breaded.
And then breaded again.
And breaded again.
So if you like bread, you're really in for it, right?
There's not a lot of breading. There's a lot more crab than there is anything else in there.
Okay, so here's my question. 3 days to make?
Yes, 3 days to make.
30 seconds to eat. Wow. Smoking hot. And really good. Remember, off the menu, in the kitchen, the big ones.
And once you're done eating, how about burning off some of those calories with a little flamenco dancing on your own?